Yeah, hey everyone, quick video. So I still have another chance to talk about Kell Brook. I've seen the fight now. It was a good knockout. Kell Brook knocked out, or TKO'd, whatever you want to call it, Amir Khan. Yeah, it was just a one-sided fight. To be honest, the size difference is too much. Amir Khan just, you know, natural lightweight, moved up to light welterweight. Yeah, Kell just a big, strong welterweight. I just think the size and strength was too much. It was a one-sided fight, 6 rounds. Every time he hit Khan, Khan's legs were going. I don't know how he lasted 6 rounds. Took a lot of punishment, very brave guy. I don't know why he took the fight. I just think the size difference. If you look at when I sparred Kell Brook, he never knocked me that I just... When I sparred Kell Brook, and the punishment came, I just took a knee, just, you know, went down for the count. So fortunately, I never got beaten up the way Amir Khan did. And obviously, nothing wrong with it. I'm not mocking him, and I wish Khan well. They've both been great ambassadors for boxing, especially British boxing. Both of them have performed and proven themselves on the world level. You know, they're coming to the end of their careers, especially Khan. I mean, I'm just guessing. He might have one more fight. He might try to go out on a win, but I'd probably say he'll just retire. It's going to be difficult to go for another camp. And who's going to train him? He's going to stay with Bo Jackson. What's his name? Is he going to stay with Terence Crawford and these guys? Or, because obviously they're going to be disappointed. He's made our gym look bad. Or is he going to jump to another trainer? Is he going to go for an opponent who's a bit of a lower level? We'll see. But I wish Khan well. I've always liked him. I almost sparred him. But what happened was he went to America for his training camp. So even though we had a conversation at the first press conference, because he was going to go train in America, we couldn't really spar. But yeah, you know, him and me would have done something, met up in the gym. So he's retired, he's obviously just had his fight. I don't really want to bother him, but I'm sure him and me will cross paths soon enough. And as for Kell Brook, I very much doubt he's going to retire. Mentally, you're going to be sky high right now. He could fight Conor Benn, he could fight Chris Eubank. Who else could he? I think the most obvious choice will probably be Conor Benn. Eubank's quite big. We all know what happened last time he took on someone above his natural weight class, Mr. Golovkin. Then you had the loss to Errol Spence, the loss to Terence Crawford. I think he can beat Conor Benn. I think that's the most logical fight. And obviously, it's all about money. If I was in Kell Brook's position, I'd continue to fight. I mean, the money's hard to turn down. Where else are you going to make that kind of money? Anyone else? Yeah, those are probably the main choices. Maybe you could fight a Liam Smith or someone like that. But the Conor Benn fight's a bigger money fight, so we'll see what happens anyway. But all the best to Khan and Brook. It's been a long time. I've known those guys since I first met Amir Khan in 2010. I first met Amir Khan in August 2009. I met Muhammad Ali that day. And I first met Kell Brook in 2010. It's been a long time, so I wish them both well. You know, I hope they retire from boxing with their brains and their bank account intact. I hope they don't waste their money. That's never good. Take care. Thanks for watching.